good times. There's gonna be good times, good times.
I know there's gonna be
work every day till we meet ends. Half it on it up on the weekends. Boss a toast to your real friend. Tell me why you're drinking, girl.
I know there's gonna be
good times. Running up out of money.
Welcome back to my blog. So that was just the intro to my morning, what I usually do. So I usually wake up straight away, lay in my bed, have a glass of warm lemon water, room temperature lemon water, brush my teeth, and then get ready for the day. So I work from home on Mondays and Wednesdays, which is why I'm at home at the moment, and I'd usually go to the gym before as well, but I had a bit of a heavy weekend, so I slept through my alarm and I didn't go this morning, but I might go to a class at lunchtime, just get my fitness routine in as soon. I'm not going to be able to work out, but it'll be worth it in the end. So this vlog is more about recovery and a lot of the best ways to recover quickly and easier, good things to eat, that sort of thing. Before I even started my research, I saw my surgeon Mark Solomus post on his Instagram account. He said that pineapple is one of the good things to eat for a quick, well, not quick recovery, but swelling and bruising is meant to help with that, which I'm so happy about because I'm obsessed with pineapple. So definitely going to be on the pineapple up until my surgery and then after, just to make sure I'm like full of pineapple. So that's a good one. Oh, resting wise, I know it's very obvious that you're supposed to be resting, but the first 3 weeks are the most important part of your recovery. And they say the first 7 to 10 days, you should literally be resting and not doing anything. After that, obviously just, you can do things, but just be really careful. I did see with research as well that it's good to like go for a walk, which I'm assuming would be like on the second week. Maybe I think that's just to like move around a little bit. So yeah, that's another good one to do. Another thing that I read, which is kind of a given again, is to just limit your salt intake. Salt increases fluid retention, so it kind of just can aggravate the swelling, and then, you know, no one's going to want to have a swollen face longer than they have to. So that was another one, and that's up to 2 weeks after you've had the surgery as well, and then after that you can, you know, start having a little bit more if you want, don't go crazy. But I think for me, I'm just going to be having things like soups because it's going to be hard to chew as well. The thing that I found in the research is to make sure you have soft foods. So things like mashed potato, sweet potato, oatmeal, smoothies, that sort of thing. So I'll definitely just be having like vegetables and making soups with it. My boyfriend does the best chicken soup ever, so I'll definitely be getting him to make that as well. What else did I find out? I'm sure, I think I mentioned it in my last blog, is the nurses told me to wear baggy clothing and make sure you've got buttons in the middle, just because you're not going to be wanting to like lift things over your head. It's going to be irritating and you shouldn't really be moving your head around too much. So I got two nighties. They're so cute. Not sure if you can be able to see because they're quite long. So I got this one. This is from George. It's so cute. It's really, really long and baggy and it's got buttons in the middle. And then I got, I'm dropping everything. And then I got this one as well, which is my fave. Cute. It's pink and it's got little love hearts on it. So yeah, that one's huge as well. It's really, really soft and it's got buttons as well. So I'm not gonna have to be lifting anything off. They're really cute. What else can I tell you? Sleeping, that's another thing. I'm sure if you guys have researched it before, everyone knows that you have to be sleeping in an upright position. So even if you're laying down a little bit, you shouldn't really be full back. You need to kind of, your head needs to be able to be straight, if you know what I mean. So one of my friends, Josie, bless her, she's amazing. She's got one of those round pillows that like go around you, kind of like a pregnancy pillow, because she had surgery once as well. She said that I can use that, so I can just put it around me, so I'm kind of just going to be upright a little bit, which is amazing, because I feel like that's going to be one of the toughest parts, is sleeping, because you're going to be so exhausted from the surgery, and then not being able to sleep because you're not comfortable is going to be like the worst. But luckily, I'm not one of those people that actually likes sleeping flat. Like, my boyfriend literally sleeps on, like, the thinnest pillow. He just lies flat, but I have to have, like, two pillows and then something underneath just so my neck's a little bit lifted. Otherwise, I'm just, like, so uncomfortable. So I'm hoping it's not going to be too bad, but time will tell. If you don't follow my Instagram account, then you should. It's Rhino Experience. I'm posting every day on there at the moment. I'm taking a selfie every day, or not taking a selfie, or showing photos of me being awkward with like my nose and trying to hide it. Just so, like, up until that time, it's sort of like, not the negative times, but all of the times that I'm like upset and trying to hide my nose. And then obviously take you through once I've had it done and all of that, and then all my improvements as well. So excited. So yeah, definitely follow me on Instagram if you're not, to keep up with my journey. And like I mentioned before, I'm gonna try and add in fitness stuff at the moment, but I've just been like crazy busy. I didn't get a chance to today, but I will try, and I will bring you on my swab appointment if I'm allowed to bring my camera in and everything else. Yeah, so if you have questions about anything, or unsure, or you just need advice, anything like that, because I know it's such a big thing to do, like it's taken me so long. Like I said in my last blog, I was 13 when it happened, and literally ever since then I've wanted a nose job. I've been to consultations, I've nearly booked, I've like paid deposits and stuff, and then I've just ended up being like, I can't do this, and I didn't do it. But now I'm fully in it, everything's paid off, I'm literally counting down the days, I'm so excited. So yeah, if you just want to talk or advice or anything like that, then definitely let me know, and I'm more than happy to help. Thanks for watching, guys. One last thing on a side note. I have wanted Gymshark leggings and top for ages, and I've just been really good and said, don't spend that much money, you have so many workout clothes, you don't need it. And then the other day I was just like, you know what, stuff it, I'm gonna wear it all the time, so I'm just gonna buy it. So I bought it, and here is a photo. I'm literally obsessed. It just makes everything look so perfect and so comfy. It doesn't fall down either. It's just like life changing. I just had to add that in.